Good evening, and welcome to Array Music's first live streamed concert of the season. I can't really tell you how happy I am to be back playing music in the same room with the audience, and to be listening to a group of string quartet players play music together with to other people in the room. It's so lovely after such a long break. And along with that, it's so nice to be delivering a land acknowledgement and looking people in the eyes with my feet standing on the ground of the actual place that I'm giving the acknowledgement for. It means a lot to be back, and so I hope that we can continue, and I really thank all of you for being here and for tuning in. Array Music operates on ancient land that has seen and supported humanity for 15,000 years. It's the land of the Petun First Nations, the Seneca, and more recently the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation. The land is subject to the Dish With One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, an agreement between the Haudenosaunee Confederacy and the Anishinaabeg Nation to peaceably care and share the resources in the Great Lakes region. Today, Toronto remains a meeting place and is still home to Indigenous peoples from across Turtle Island. Thank you all for coming. Before we start, I want to thank the Array staff, particularly Dan Tapper, Connor McSweeney, and Sandra Bell, who have all worked incredibly hard behind the scenes to get this concert together. I want to thank Chioko herself, who has put in even more time than one normally expects from a composer to create all the video work that you'll see that's sort of bespoke for this performance. And also need to thank the Ontario Arts Council, the Canada Council for the Arts, and the Toronto Arts Council, and all the many foundations and individual donors that make the season possible. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy the show. Oh, one last thing. I will be on Zoom after the concert, and along with anyone else who's in the space that wants to sit around and chat. I'm going to be on Zoom, and we'll be dropping a Zoom link in the chat at the end of the show. So if you out there in the ether world want to join in and sit around and talk a little bit, stick around after the very last piece, and we'll put that Zoom link in the chat, and you can join us. So thank you very much, and we'll all talk and see you soon. Bye bye.
Sine waves have no timbre, no spectrum. Transparent. What I especially like about constellations is how the relationship between the piano and the sine waves is different in each part. The sine waves seem to show the continuum between the piano strings. In a way, they animate its notes. It was based on a single set of dots, which I had connected in various ways, producing four different visual scenarios. Taking inspiration from those drawings, I created a musical scenario in which some of the notes are joined by rising or falling sine waves, with the two tuning systems creating beating whenever the pitches are different.
I found the title, Her Teeth Were White, in Shaking the Pumpkin, a collection of poems and songs by North American First Nations peoples, compiled by Jerome Rothenberg. I was inspired and energized by the refreshingly direct and playful texts describing many paradoxical truths of life, of living, of being alive. In Gradients of Detail, I tried to compose a work made up almost entirely of clusters. Pitches lying within the critical band. An acoustical concept of a bandwidth within which different pitches cannot be differentiated by the brain. They fuse. There is a certain kind of beating